All right.
So, your weekend was very good. Yes. Anderson's weekend was excellent.
Yes.
Julius, how was your weekend?
Yeah, my weekend is normal. I stay in my house with the Zinia and the end. My week.
You forgot your week. Thank you. Thank you, guys. I love you. I love you. I'm going to love you next week.
Next week. Thank you so much.
All right. Okay, guys. So, you don't remember your weekend?
Yes.
Like a child.
Did you?
Was necessary pick up him in his house.
Julius, can't you declare? Cueca virada. Next time I bring calcinha virada. Delicious. Wow.
I see.
I don't know the name.
Let me bring some. Well, my weekend wasn't too good because a friend of mine passed away. She had a surgery. She had a surgery Thursday morning and everything was okay. And then Friday evening she went to her house. Everything just fine. And Saturday morning she had a cardiorespiratory. And the surgery wasn't something complicated because it's gallbladder, vesicular, and took the stones from them. Nothing complicated. And she passed away. So it was shocking, very shocking. So Saturday I went to the funeral home for Sally. The burial was in the morning, Sunday morning. And the whole weekend was that. Shocking, shocking, shocking. And I'm, well, at least I'm glad we got in touch with him. Because 20 years ago, I dated her oldest son. He was 17, I was 24. Oh, no. Mm-hmm. I think you're a pedophile. Oh.
I think.
But we broke up in Central Central. And like a couple of months ago, because she was living here in Portugal, called there. And she said, I come here to visit me, etc. So shocking. Very shocking. Alright, well. Very sad, yes, but what can we do? Alright, I sent some exercises to on WhatsApp. Oh, yeah. You saw it. Alright.
I don't understand you. The boss?
You didn't understand the
more the history. I don't know. It's because the massacre?
Yes, it's talking about massacre.
Massacre.
But this is not the main idea. The main idea is
the disarmament.
Yes, it's about gun control.
The acontecimento?
The events.
The event, events.
The events.
Was in the Tanzania.
Tasmania.
Tasmania, Australia, and the United States.
United States.
United States.
Yes.
And the the first country in 1996, yes?
I don't remember the date.
1996. And then, after Australia, don't know. And the United States, I listened about the, speak, Obama speak. That when happened in the Wednesday was the worst day of the governor, the Obama. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Obama said.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Obama meeting one team for for situation about the disarmament. Yes.
Yeah, the text is saying, it's showing the same event in two countries. Okay, but let's listen. All right, let's listen up. Stop a little bit. All right.
café y muchas vinos.
Tanzania.
Oh, yes.
Tanzania in Africa. Tasmania, Australia.
Australia. Next to Australia.
Yes, it's a small island close to the continent. Okay, here we go again.
The people in
April 28th, 1996, in a cafe in Tasmania. One man pulled a semi-automatic weapon out of his bag and began shooting tourists and staff at the historic Port Arthur P. O'Connell colony. By the time he was finished, he had killed 35 people. This was just one of several mass shootings in Australia between the 1970s and 1990s. Following the 1996 massacre, Prime Minister Howard initiated a serious crackdown on gun ownership. Howard worked together with the Australian government. They made a swift decision to restrict gun ownership. The government also organised a program to buy back weapons that had already been sold. Over 600,000 guns were retrieved. 15 years later, there were still no new mass shootings to report in Australia. It's a different story in the US. Since the 1980s, mass shootings have occurred in several public places, including malls, schools, places of worship. After a mass shooting, the sale of guns always skyrockets. Though studies prove that easy access to guns results in high murder rates, surveys show that many Americans still believe in the right to bear arms. One of the worst massacres in US history took place at Virginia Tech University in 2007. A student suffering from mental illness killed 35 students. Opponents of gun control argued that students and staff couldn't protect themselves because they were in a gun-free safety zone. In 2012, a week before Christmas, a young man entered Sandy Hook Elementary School in Connecticut and went on a shooting rampage. He killed 6 staff members and 20 first graders with a legally purchased gun. US President Obama broke down in tears as he addressed the union. He called it the worst day in his presidency. Like Prime Minister Howard, Obama immediately organized a team to address gun control laws. His proposals called for a ban on assault weapons and mandatory background checks for all gun buyers. Within a month of the shooting, 1,000 more Americans had been killed by guns. On April 28, 1996, in a cafe in Tasmania, a young man pulled a semi-automatic...
Okay, so... What could you understand, the main idea? Nothing? Name what he said? The massacre, shootings...
Attacking schools, universities, a number of people were killed, and programs to protect the people, set fires for the president.
He is speaking about the 50, 34 people divided. Yeah?
Students and staff.
Students, staff, this is in Australia. Yes? Mm-hmm. In Australia.
In US?
In US? More than, wow, many, many people.
Hello? Oh. Não vai te tocar aí o presente da Lara. Não!
Yes, delicious.
Então, eu queria mesmo, danadinha.
This cat is terrible.
Yes.
It is terrible, my God. So, but could you understand the two different policies addressing the problem?
No.
No?
No.
You didn't understand what was done in Australia and in US? No. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I've just sent on your cell phone on WhatsApp an exercise. It's regarding the vocabulary, okay? Take your cell phone, please. Super delicious.
All right.
Stella, would you like some more coffee?
No, thank you.
It's not good? The coffee is not good, you know.
Okay, no, it's very good. Yeah, but I had the breakfast.
All right.
I'm precisando tomar cafezinho depois do tempo.
Okay? You're gonna, yes, do it with Juarez. I can't use the cell phone to bore you. So, we have two columns of words, right? Mm-hmm. Anderson, read the column A, please.
A?
Yeah, the first column, sorry.
Penal colony.
Penal colony.
Delicious.
Massa. Initiate.
Massacre. Initiate.
Initiate. Track down.
Okay.
Swift.
Swift.
Swift. Retrieve.
Retrieve.
Skyrocket. Easy access. Mental illness.
Mental illness.
Opportunity.
Okay.
Rampage.
Rampage.
Mandatory.
Mandatory. Finished?
Finished.
Okay, Stella, the other column, please.
Quiet. Should be the one to leave something. A person or group on the other side of a conflict or debate. A serious regulation to prevent future crime, uncontrollable violent behavior, to suddenly go up in numbers, a remote place for prisoners that is difficult to escape from, not difficult to get, find, and use, to get something back that you had before. Sickness that affects on one's things and emotions. Quick, the violent killing of men.
So, we have two columns. We need to match them. Okay? Juarez, number one. What is a penal colony? What is a penal colony?
Letter G?
Read for me, please.
A remote place of prisoner that is difficult to escape from.
Yes. Very good. We had several penal colonies in Brazil. I was watching that TV show, Brazil Seen from Above, Brasil Visto por Cima. And I think in Angra, there was in Angra, or in Rio dos Lagos, Rio de Janeiro, I think, yes. Ilha Grande, there was a huge penal colony, but now it was put down.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. But I think the most famous one is Alcatraz, né?
Alcatraz.
I think.
And because of the movies.
The movies, the book,
yes.
Né? So, it's very famous. It doesn't exist anymore, but it's still very famous.
Why? Because of the river?
Yeah, because
very
difficult. The whole area is difficult to swim because of the wave, the sharks, even the access to the place was very difficult. But now it doesn't exist anymore. It's now a museum for visitation. All right, Stella, next one. have many, many stories. Here in Brazil, normally and sadly, we hear many stories of massacres. Favelas, the prisons, and the school, up north, the Native Americans being massacred. All right, Anderson is gonna get cold. While he's thinking, next Friday, normal class, okay?
Next.
Yes, normal class.
Yes.
Next.
Yes, because we have the holiday, Thursday, né?
Yes?
Yes, Independence.
Oh, okay, seven days.
September 7th.
Ah, normal.
Friday, normal. You are not gonna travel, are you?
No, I am not.
Yeah. Well, Anderson, we know he's not gonna travel, né?
He is.
He's gonna work.
Yes, work and travel every day.
Yeah.
He travels every day.
Yeah.
To
Boituva.
Boituva to Sorocaba.
Yeah, from Boituva to Sorocaba, exactly. Okay. I'll send you guys the text and you take a look on it.
It's beautiful. The glass beautiful. It's terrible.
Ah, because of the sun?
Oh, no. The dedo mesmo. The dedo manchado.
Essa película não é assim.
Não.
Não,
não tinha. When I bought it. So, didn't have the amento.
You need to speak a little bit louder because the camera is not gonna capture the sound.
Okay.
Yes. Very loud. All right. Okay.
Don't remember. Sorry.
It's not a new model.
But
yeah,
it's a new model. This one, but the
2017.
All right. But what is not recent? Because you said I need to use from another cell phone.
No, the película.
Ah, all right.
When I bought it, they didn't have special película to it. So it was adapted from another cellular to
all right.
Because it's the
shorter.
Small, yes, shorter.
Okay.
You know the price? You speak about the price, please.
price? No.
No? Why? I used it. 2000.
No, 2070 is the modelo.
Model.
No.
Costela do japonês.
Ah, yes.
I think it was
all day.
Around the
Martin.
700 reais or 1,000 reais?
700 reais. I picked it up in a promotion.
Ah.
Yes. Relâmpago promotion.
Ah, because
yes, in
you were supporting Butchie's more expensive is mine.
More expensive than mine.
Yes.
Mine one.
I don't know because
one
I.
1,000. 1,000.
Oh, I don't know. I'm sorry because I was in Esther. Is somebody there was a promotion relâmpago.
Okay, let's do that promotion.
What was the last before?
Ah,
so I run to,
yes.
to buy it.
Yes. I have a cell phone, but my cell phone is was herdado.
Yes. Yes, like mine, it was inherited. Yeah.
Yes. So the real price, I don't know.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna play the audio and you have the text now, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
My birthday, April
28th.
Mm-hmm. On April 28th, 1996, in a cafe in Tasmania, a young man pulled a semi-automatic weapon out of his bag and began shooting tourists and staff at the historic Port Arthur Penal Colony. By the time he was finished, he had killed 35 people. This was just one of several mass shootings in Australia between the 1970s and 1990s. Following the 1996 massacre, Prime Minister Howard initiated a serious crackdown on gun ownership. Howard worked together with the Australian government. They made a swift decision to restrict gun ownership. The government also organized a program to buy back weapons that had already been sold. Over 600,000 guns were retrieved. 15 years later, there were still no new mass shootings to report in Australia. It's a different story in the US. Since the 1980s, mass shootings have occurred in several public places, including malls, schools, places of worship. After a mass shooting, the sale of guns always skyrockets. Though studies prove that easy access to guns results in high murder rates, surveys show that many Americans still believe in the right to bear arms. One of the worst massacres in US history took place at Virginia Tech University in 2007. A student suffering from mental illness killed 35 students. Opponents of gun control argued the students and staff couldn't protect themselves because they were in a gun-free safety zone. In 2012, a week before Christmas, a young man entered Sandy Hook Elementary School in Connecticut and went on a shooting rampage. He killed 6 staff members and 20 first graders with a legally purchased gun. U.S. President Obama broke down in tears as he addressed the union. He called it the worst day in his presidency. Like Prime Minister Howard, Obama immediately organized a team to address gun control, laws. His proposals called for a ban on assault weapons and mandatory background checks for all gun buyers. Within a month of the shooting, 1,000 more Americans had been killed by guns.
All right.
Okay, no, so I hear you. Please, would you take this?
No. Again? Yes. Okay.
On April 28, 1996, in a cafe in Tasmania, a young man pulled a semi-automatic weapon out of his bag and began shooting tourists and staff at the historic Port Arthur Penal Colony. By the time he was finished, he had killed 35 people. This was just one of several mass shootings in Australia between the 1970s and 1990s. Following the 1996 massacre, Prime Minister Howard initiated a serious crackdown on gun ownership. Howard worked together with the Australian government. They made a swift decision to restrict gun ownership. The government also organized a program to buy back weapons that had already been sold. Over 600,000 guns were retrieved. 15 years later, there were still no new mass shootings to report in Australia. It's a different story in the US. Since the 1980s, mass shootings have occurred in several public places, including malls, schools, places of worship. After a mass shooting, the sale of guns always skyrockets. Though studies prove that easy access to guns results in high murder rates, surveys show that many Americans still believe in the right to bear arms. One of the worst massacres in US history took place at Virginia Tech University in 2007. A student suffering from mental illness killed 35 students. Opponents of gun control argued the students and staff couldn't protect themselves because they were in a gun-free safety zone. In 2012, a week before Christmas, a young man entered Sandy Hook Elementary School in Connecticut and went on a shooting rampage. He killed 6 staff members and 20 first graders with a legally purchased gun. U.S. President Obama broke down in tears as he addressed the Union. He called it the worst day in his presidency. Like Prime Minister Howard, Obama immediately organized a team to address gun control laws. His proposals called for a ban on assault weapons and mandatory background checks for all gun buyers. Within a month of the shooting, 1,000 more Americans had been killed by guns.
Okay.
Yes.
So, now, how would you summarize the text? Okay, each one talks a little bit about the text, the audio, the text. Okay? Anderson, what is the text about? What is it talking about? Is it talking about food, clothing, guns?
So the text is about use guns to massacre in several places around the world, and about the decision from the president, ministers, and to protect the people. Each
Mm-hmm. Okay. What was the difference between Australia and U.S. towards massacres, shootings, etc.?
Australia?
Yes. How did they approach the problem?
Mm-hmm. Yes. The Australian the people are the one person that the gun people
kill people
is in the student.
A student.
Mm-hmm. And the killed six.
Is it recording? Yes. Okay, so what's your opinion first about the text? Which give me your opinion.
Please, Charles.
Take this chair here.
No?
All right.
So I think the text is an interesting text because we could see that they have a gun. It's not don't me. We are protected. Because I think gun is better though, because we can do something wrong and when the nervous is
jump out of your skin, get on your nerves. When you get on your nerves,
yes, we can do something. So the text showed us that the government, when the government had a good idea to prevent the crime, did it right. And it's different about Australia and
USA, yes.
And Australia, the government had a good idea and took off the street the guns. And different from the US, that the people have right and buy a gun. Everyone has a right to life. Mm-hmm. The crime never stops.
You never stop. Yes. Yes. Guys.
This problem is different. Different about many countries.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think they
the size
of the country is below is different. For example, real estate is the big country.
Mm-hmm.
And different law, different states have law. Australia,
Tasmania.
Tasmania is little.
Yeah, but the crime happened in Tasmania, but other crimes
in Australia.
Australia is big.
Yeah. Uh-huh. The governor of Australia, governor, stopped the situation because, in my opinion, was hard.
Good. They were hard on the
yes. Yeah, hard. Yes. In the UN state is different because the mind of Obama is very good.
Mm-hmm.
But the Congress, UN state, is mixed.
Yes.
Mixed and the same of Brazil.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes. Brazil. Yes. We are very similar.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The money mm-hmm. is.
Yes.
The money.
Yes.
But
money talks.
Money talks.
In English, dinheiro que manda, in English, dinheiro fala. Money talks.
Talks.
Money talks.
And the test about this, problem, the control is interesting. The control of the army.
Yes.
But they stopped about killed. Is they believe the money?
Train
in the school about the kids.
Train the kids to use the guns?
No, about no use the gun.
Ah, okay.
Don't use the gun.
Mm-hmm.
And the this in the Australia, UN state, right? Australia stopped about the
yes.
situation.
Yes.
Right? And this is important the attitude.
The attitude
of the government, the Australian government.
Mm-hmm.
And it's complicated in another country.
Yes.
Another country. Because when the people, the situation, economic situation, the people are
nervous.
And in the street, in the family, and the mind is different. Different person.
Yeah.
The reaction, the emotion
mm-hmm.
is different.
Yeah.
One don't have one law hard is different about this.
Mm-hmm. Anderson. Oh my God.
Hello. Good morning.
Oh. Dormiu.
Dormiu.
Eu não sei se dormir agora.
Good morning.
O que
deu? Austrália solved the problem about massacre.
Shooting.
But
massacre.
Not about the bio gun and a if you get a gun?
No, because now there, nobody can have a gun.
Nobody?
No, not even the police officers. The police officers, they don't know. No.
But there are thieves from there.
Yes, you can get in the black market.
Mm-hmm.
But the penalty for people that is caught with a gun mm-hmm. is terrible. Even if you didn't kill anybody. Mm-hmm. If you are caught with a gun, yes, because, example, you need to remove totally guns from the streets.
So, Australia is a country
we should follow, yes.
Solve the problem.
It's a big country.
Yeah.
You see, I'm going to send you a text because next week we are going to continue on this talk.
Mm-hmm.
Two countries where almost every single person has a gun.
Mm-hmm.
Canada and Iceland. Iceland. Almost everybody has a gun. Have you ever heard shooting in Canada? Iceland? We don't even heard about Iceland. That's the thing. That's the thing. The economic situation is
level.
The level is 97% of the country has the same economical level. The CEO in a company doesn't get 50,000 in the cleaning, 1,800 helps, no. The guy that cleaned the company is going to receive 5,000. You see all 10,000. Because
it's
yes, it's not to walk.
Move
it
to
there.
5,000.
And the CEO, no more than 10,000. Because the inequality, the social economic inequality is the prime minister kids studied in public schools. They have private and public schools, but they prefer the public schools because it's already paid with the tax. So it's getting paid to the guns. I'm gonna send a text. And then you can compare that one thing people, the lobbyists for the gun, they say that it's not the gun that killed the person.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's true. It's not the gun. It's the person behind the gun.
Mm-hmm.
No, we need to focus the person.
Mm-hmm.
And understand, my countries, big countries like Canada, that many people have guns and we don't hear about shootings, and small countries like example, let's say, I don't hear about shootings in Peru, in Bolivia, I don't hear. Do you?
I
don't either. It's only US, Brazil,
mm-hmm.
Venezuela. But the shooting is more. But anyway,
but
you understand? No, go ahead.
But you speak that Canada, the level the people is
the same.
In the same.
Yes.
But why the people?
Mostly, it's another interesting question the text talks about. Mostly hunting. Yes.
Palavras pequenas?
No. Rifles.
I like.
They had rifles. Mm-hmm. But for hunting.
Hunting is
caçar.
Caçar?
Yes. Because they have the open seasons for a deer, etc. In Iceland, the same. So they don't have guns to protect themselves. Because the society is not a violent society. And why is not a violent society? Because the economic inequality doesn't exist. If it exists, it's real low.
Yes, the economic saving, then the people don't it's necessary. Robot.
Yes.
With here.
Exactly. Yes. Yes. Because everybody has the same opportunity to buy a house, to have a car, to travel, to buy good clothes. Everybody. But here, no. But the commercial is for everybody. Yes, the commercial doesn't say, oh, only people that has money can buy Nike. Okay, no. Commercial fala, Nike is for everybody. Eat at McDonald's for everybody, right? Aí, it's difficult. One kid that wants but can't have. Mas o comercial tá falando que ela tem o direito. Wants. Agora, the question is, how heavy guns reaches favelas? How guns that belong to army reaches favela? How? Because they don't buy.
Mystery.
Yes.
This is a mystery.
Yes.
Yeah.
How a missile reaches favela? I cannot buy.
This is the
mystery.
Yeah, but somebody
is receiving a money to do it. Yes.
And how that person has the access to army weapons?
Belong to arms. The person belong
of to arms. Because we don't find the army guns at the stores.
We don't have access to it.
We don't have access. So how they reach favelas? Don't convince me that the black market is yes. the criminal can buy a gun, but we can't.
There is somebody inside the arms. Then give permission.